We're learning more details about the American Airlines pilot who got sick during a flight and then died. The pilot's wife is also speaking out about her husband. As CBS4's Don Champion reports, the first officer calmly requested an emergency landing and safely landed the plane.
Syracuse American 550 is out of 15,000 for 5,000. A medical emergency. Captain is incapacitated. Request handling for runway 10 landing.
Emergency personnel were waiting for the jet when it touched down. Passengers said the crew acted calmly.
Now, when we landed, we didn't know the magnitude of what was going on. All we saw was the fire trucks, the EMS.
The pilot, 57-year-old Michael Johnston, had been flying professionally for 25 years. CBS News confirmed he died in the cockpit, the coroner says, of natural causes. Johnston suffered from heart issues and had double bypass surgery in 2006. His wife said he felt fine when he left.
He said he'd spent the last couple weeks working on losing weight, had lost about 10 pounds, and said, I feel better than I felt in a long time.
A crew member death in flight is a rare occurrence, but aviation experts say the 147 passengers were never in danger.
The pilot that is sitting in the right seat, which is the first officer in this particular case, is highly qualified, clearly qualified to be able to take over, bring the aircraft down as quickly and as safely as possible for a safe landing.
Don Champion, CBS 4 News.
Well, the FAA says seven pilots of U.S. airliners and one charter pilot have died during flights since 1994. A replacement crew was brought in to fly the passengers of this flight to Boston.